Hi, I'm Mark Bittman for NewsHour Weekend's Future of Food. People have been making veggie burgers as long as they've been making meat burgers. And the question is, how do you make it taste really good? This is a recipe I've developed over probably 10 years, constantly tinkering and improving, I hope. And I'd put it up against almost anything at this point. It's pretty simple. It uses all honest, natural ingredients. So, 2 cups of black beans. I like black for this, they're very meaty. These are soaked porcini mushrooms. You buy dry porcinis, you soak them in boiling water for 5 or 10 minutes and they get soft and pliable. Really important. You could use any dried mushrooms. Oats, which is sort of for binding and for body. A little soy sauce, a tablespoon or so. This is a mixture of cumin and pimenton. Pimenton is smoked paprika. Has a little kick too. About a teaspoon of each. Some chopped garlic, always essential. Some cilantro, which you don't need to bother to chop because the food processors are gonna do that for you. And we need some salt. And just for good measure. So depending how wet your beans were to begin with, you may or may not need to add extra liquid or add some more oats. If you need extra liquid, you could use bean soaking liquid or bean cooking liquid. Even better is the liquid that you use to soak the porcinis, because that's like mushroom stock. You can do this with a potato masher. The disadvantage of doing it with a food processor is you don't want a puree here. You want to chop this. You want to like chop meat. You want to chop this, but you want some texture left. You want some chew. So you have to be careful. The easiest way to be careful is just to pulse until it looks good. This is really good. It's good to let this rest for a little bit, especially in the refrigerator, just to give it a little bit more coagulating power. So I'm gonna do that for about 10 minutes and then we'll proceed. Okay, it really is 10 minutes, or was in my time. It's good to preheat the pan a little bit, just for a couple minutes, medium low heat. And then you want olive oil. And while that's heating, you see you've got a very, very ground meat-like mixture here. And it will hold together. You can make meatballs with it, you make meatloaf with it, but we're making patties. So you want that kind of sizzling, but gently. You don't want it going crazy. 4 or 5 minutes per side. There's no rare here, it's all cooked. And you don't want to mess with it too much. But as you can see, they're pretty tough little guys. I'm gonna go toast some buns. You treat it like a burger. Anything you want on there is fair game. Ketchup, pickles, mayo, et cetera, et cetera. We're gonna be eating less beef. We're gonna be eating less meat in general. We're gonna be eating less beef. It's not exactly a challenge to put together a good veggie burger. Although people are spending millions, tens of millions, hundreds of millions of dollars to figure it out, you can do it in your house in 15 minutes right now. Join us for the PBS NewsHour Weekend series, The Future of Food.